What are angels? Angels have existed since the beginning of creation. They are beings from the lower part of the subtle region of heaven, Swarga. They are the lowest in the hierarchy of positive subtle beings. Their primary purpose is to act as messengers for lower level deities in the lower subtle region of heaven. Deities speak in the language of light, whereas we humans speak in the language of sound. Angels therefore act as step-down transformers, carrying messages from lower-level deities to deserving beings in a language they can understand. This is primarily through the medium of putting thoughts in their minds. By deserving beings, we mean humans on earth and subtle bodies in the nether region, Bhavarlok, who have some background of spiritual practice or merits. The messages are generally about how to address a particular worldly issue. About 5% of the time angels themselves also give worldly advice. As their duty is mainly on earth, most of them are earthbound. When they are not delivering messages, they lead a life devoted to experiencing pleasures in the lower subtle region of heaven after death. Different types of angels. Seraphim angels. The seraphim angels are the angels closest to God. These angels encircle his throne and emit an intense, fiery light representing his light, the loving light of God. Seraphim are considered fiery serpents, and the other divine beings may not view them. There are a total of 4 seraphim, and each has 4 faces and 6 wings. When seraphim appear on earth, they prefer to take the forms of tall, thin, clean-cut human embodiments while leaving their fiery serpent forms behind in heaven. Cherubim angels, plural of cherub. The cherubim angels are the divine keepers of celestial records and hold the knowledge of God. The cherub angels are sent to earth when there is a great need with matters of most importance, like when humankind was expelled from the Garden of Eden. Ancient art depicts the cherubim as sphinx-like and winged creatures with human faces. Not the fat babies with wings that now grace greeting cards and book covers. There are now 3 cherubim angels, Ophaniel, Rikbeel, and Zophiel. From the original 4 cherub in heaven, Lucifer was a cherub before his fall from grace in heaven. Thrones angels. The thrones appear to have the weirdest appearance because they appear as great glowing wheels covered with many eyes. The thrones serve as God's chariot and dispense his judgment to carry out his desires for us. The thrones are considered heavenly governors, attempting to strike a balance between matter and spirit, good and bad. Dominations angels / dominions angels. The dominations / dominions receive seraphim and cherubim's orders, then pass those orders onto the lower angel classes for execution. They are like the upper management of the angel order / angel choir. Tzadkiel, sometimes called Hashmel, is the chief in charge of the dominions angels. Principalities angels. These angelic beings are seen as rays of light. The principalities oversee everything, making sure everything, and guide our entire world, nations, cities, and towns, and more importantly, in charge of religion and politics. Principalities are in charge of managing the earthly duties of the angels below them. Powers angels. The angels of power appear in their celestial form as brightly colored, hazy fumes. The powers are the angels of birth and D3 at TH and are border patrol angels of heaven. Some people believe that the powers keep demons at bay, while St. Paul believed that the powers were the evil angels. Powers are responsible for advising in religion, theology, and ideology. Some believe that the powers are the most like humans because of their vulnerability to the act of sinning. Virtues angels. The virtues are shaped like sparks of light, focusing on maintaining the natural world and inspiring living things in things like science. They are also responsible for taking orders from upper angels and turning those orders into miracles for the deserving. They usually take their earthly forms as musicians, artists, healers, and scientists who work with the power of love / physics. The 2 angels present at the ascension of Jesus are believed to be virtues for that heavenly miracle. Archangels angels. Archangels are the guardians of humankind. Archangels appear in human form with huge wings set on their backs. The most well-known archangels are Michael, Gabriel, and Raphael. Angels are those who are in charge of delivering individuals with direct messages from God. Angels safeguard households and individuals from evil and demons. Angels nurture, counsel, and heal individual people for God. Everyone has their own personal angel known as their guardian angel with us daily. What are guardian angels? There is no such thing as a guardian angel. Some ancestors who have deep affinity for the family communicate to help their family members regarding worldly matters. These departed ancestors may be mistaken for the guardian angels. Ancestors who are in the range of 20-30% spiritual level can help only about deriving worldly pleasures. Only those ancestors above the spiritual level of 50% can help regarding spiritual progress. Are angels male or female? Angels can be either male or female. Only subtle entities and subtle bodies above the subtle region of heaven, i.e. in Mahaloka etc. due to their high spiritual level of over 60%, Samashti, or 70%, Vayashti, do not identify themselves with any gender. Can we see angels? As angels are subtle beings, they are not visible to the ordinary human eye. They do not appear before us. They can be seen only with the help of advanced and activated extrasensory perception, ESP, or sixth sense. Their mechanism of communication with us, humans, is through putting thoughts in our mind. Do angels have the power to answer our prayers as in fulfilling our worldly wishes? No, angels do not have the capacity to answer prayers, i.e. they cannot bestow any favor or get anything done for humans on their own. At the most, they can guide people with regard to worldly matters by putting thoughts in their minds. This happens about 5% of the time. Angels are the lowest in the positive subtle hierarchy in the universe. Their only function is to deliver messages for lower level deities in the subtle region of heaven to deserving humans or subtle bodies in the nether region. As they cannot guide us spiritually nor protect us from negative energies, they are not worthy of worship. Thank you for watching.